Students, in this video I am going to talk to 7th standard students. Students, we have been talking about animal fiber chapter. In animal fiber chapter, we have completed so many sub-concepts related to the animal fiber chapter. We have completed life cycle of silkworm, and we have also talked about story of the wool, and in the last class we have talked about the flow chart. We follow what are the steps followed in making a woolen fabric. Okay, the flow chart is important. You please remember that. That may be asked in your exams. Okay, students, you have to practice that in your notebook and present in our WhatsApp group also, students. And in this video, what I'm going to talk to you is, I'm going to talk about the people, those who are climbing the mountain Everest. Most of the people, they carry woolen fabrics in their bags. Why do they carry woolen fabrics? Do you know? Can you answer for this question on your own? You just think of. Here, actually, the people, those who are climbing Mount Everest, how is the temperature? The temperature is very cool, and the person who is climbing the Mount Everest, he may feel very cool there and he may be affected by the cool. So to protect from the cool temperature, to protect from the cool temperature, the person carries woolen fabrics. Okay, students, what is the main property of woolen fabric? Why should the person carry only woolen fabric? Why shouldn't he carry cotton or silk? Why shouldn't he carry cotton or silk or polyester? Why shouldn't he carry? Because the main property of woolen fabric is trapping the temperature. Did you understand? Trapping. Here, woolen fabric is very poor conductor of heat. Okay. Woolen fabric is what? Woolen fabric is, it's a very poor conductor of heat. Then, so what? It's a poor conductor of heat. The heat which is present inside the body is not allowed out of the body. Because if we wear the woolen fabrics, the temperature from the body will not be escaped. The hotness from the body will not be escaped because it's a very poor conductor of heat. It traps the temperature of the body and we feel hot. Okay? We feel hot. At the same time, the cool temperature which is outside the body is also trapped by the woolen fabrics. Okay, so there the woolen fabric acts as an insulator. So that means the poor conductor of heat, it doesn't allow the external temperature into the body and internal body temperature into the atmosphere. Okay, like this the body is protected from cool temperatures. Okay, and not only this, actually a question related to that explanation. See, if you are going to visit Dal Lake, where is Dal Lake present? Kashmir, right? If you are going to visit Dal Lake at which type of clothes would you like to keep in your bag? Students, note it down in your notebook. Note this question in your notebook, students. If you are going to visit Dal Lake at Kashmir, which type of clothes would you like to keep in your bag? The matter that I have explained just before, right? You just think about the answer. You will find answer for the question. Okay? And also, and for your general understanding, and one more question for you. Why? Person who caught with fire is wrapped with blanket. Students, why a person who is caught with fire is wrapped with blanket? What is the fiber used in making blanket? Wool, right? Blanket is nothing but a woolen fabric. So if a person is caught with a fire, if a person is caught with the fire, the person is covered or wrapped with blanket. To burn the fire, what does it need? It needs oxygen. Okay? When the fire is covered with the blanket, that doesn't get oxygen, the fire doesn't get oxygen, and then that will go off. So like that, the person who is caught with fire is wrapped with blanket and protected. Okay? Protected from burning. Like this. Students, almost we have completed the chapter. We came to end of the chapter. And after this, we have some keywords. Okay? Keywords of the chapter. What is the lesson name? Animal fiber. Third chapter. Okay, students. Keywords. Okay, students. I will teach about these keywords in the next video, students. Especially, let us do a separate video for keywords. Okay? This is for this video, students. Thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all.